Welcome to the journey. Today we're going to talk about how to turn impulse shopping into stone cold sales. So you've likely experienced this exact moment, I know I have, when you're on your tablet or you're on your laptop, and then all of a sudden you get distracted by an ad. And the next thing you know, you're considering buying something fun and new. Because, you know, why not? And if you think about it, it reminds me of when you're standing in line and you are distracted by all these great products on the shelves that are brightly colored. And subconsciously, it's to get you to make a quick decision to add it to your cart, buy just one more thing before you check out.
And since that's a little harder to do online, e-commerce shoppers need something more to create a sense of urgency that encourages them to buy right now. Businesses can increase revenue by designing and optimizing sites that cater to impulse shoppers. So we've got a few strategies to make it easy for impulse shoppers to navigate and buy from your website. Starting off with, just keep it simple. Keep the focus on the most valuable information for consumers, like detailed product descriptions. And once a shopper lands on their potential purchase, make sure to call to action or CTA as clear as possible. People need to know how to complete a sale. Try for almost too obvious. Your CTA should be use unambiguous terms like add to cart or purchase. Remember, impulse shopping is fickle. Keeping your product pages and CTA clear and concise is going to ensure that shoppers won't second guess their purchases.
And speak of impulse shoppers, plan for them to be on mobile. We've said it before, but everyone is shopping on their phones nowadays on the go. So if your site isn't mobile optimized, you're losing business. Recent stats from Google show that 80% of smartphone users are more likely to make a purchase from companies with mobile sites or apps that, you know, help them easily answer their questions. And to make sure that your site is mobile friendly, it's actually really easy to check. You can check on your mobile device, or you can even do a Google check where it will run through and test the page. But make sure each page displays correctly, not distorted. You don't have to pinch and poke to get to the image. Make sure then also that it loads quickly and that your mobile checkout is as seamless as your desktop version.
To add to that, you want to make sure your checkout process is a breeze. If someone is impulse shopping, getting them to act on that spontaneity and put an item in the cart is half the battle. After that, you want to make it an effortless process to finish the transaction. But first things first, when it comes to the checkout, don't force customers to sign in or create an account to complete the purchase. Research shows that 28% of cart abandonment is due to websites forcing users to create an account. Make the process fast and easy by including a guest checkout option.
Also consider offering different payment options. So think about that impulse shopper. They aren't going to want to go find their credit card, right? So alternatively, if they've been buying several items, they might be reluctant to enter their payment information for an impulse purchase. A lot of psychology there. And include additional digital payments like PayPal, Apple Pay, and these are often saved on a shopper's phone or browser, which offers them an easier route to buy the item. It just speeds things up.
And then you're gonna wanna make sure you secure your website. Even impulse shoppers are savvy shoppers. This is not their first rodeo, it's their second. But in all seriousness, 84% of Americans are shopping online for something at any given time. To counteract security worries, purchase and install an SSL certificate to secure your checkout process. And as an added bonus, Google uses security as a ranking factor. So not only will it help bolster the trust that your users have in your business, but it can potentially boost your rankings on search engines like Google.
And then be sure to test your site for ease of use. A common website design mantra is to design your site like the user is not web savvy. In fact, I have a funny story to share. There's actually a freelancer who you can pay to review your website, but he does it while he's drinking. Then see how easy it is to navigate. And while we don't suggest opening a bottle of wine or cracking open a beer and trying to A/B test your site, you can test functionality and make sure it's as simple and as straightforward as possible.
And in fact, I have my mom go ahead and test the sites that I build just to make sure that if she can do it, then anyone can do it. I love you, Mom. But online shoppers love the ease of one-click ship. Finding products from the comfort of their home and the convenience of buying with their smartphone. When you throw a little of impulsiveness into the mix, folks are all the more likely to hit that purchase button. So make your e-commerce site super easy to navigate and optimize pages for those visitors. If impulse shoppers represent a significant portion of the industry, that's valuable business that you don't want to miss.
All right, that's a wrap, but the journey doesn't need to stop here. We have over 200 videos for you to check out. So be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for tuning in. This is The Journey.